Hi guys, it's Carissa, and today I am filming my week 21 update. And I had filmed separate videos on some of what I'm going to talk about, but I realized you don't need as many details. Now that I have kind of had things worked out, you don't need as many details as what I had before. So I'm going to try to quickly include it into this video. So there was some drama with my doctor situation in week 21, which is very frustrating. Just to give you as quick a recap as I can, but still make sure that you know some of the more important facts, I had a doctor. It was an OBGYN. I had been seeing him for about a year. I didn't personally have any real problem with him. I just felt like he wasn't very interactive and didn't have a lot of information for me or questions for me about things I was doing. And this being my first pregnancy, I wouldn't mind a little bit more intervention because there's so little that I actually know. I was so focused on getting pregnant that being pregnant is a whole new world for me. So I had been seeing him without any issue, and I had recommended someone else go see him for a problem that she was having, and she had a very negative experience. In fact, if I had been in her shoes, I never would have wanted to go back, and I was actually really surprised. Well, she told someone when she was working, who then told her a bunch of horror stories about him, including that he had his license revoked for a year, or he wasn't allowed to practice for a year because he was negligent and a patient died. And the woman who told that story, which you can find if you Google it, and I did, she herself lost her ability to have more children after an incident when he delivered her last child. And just through some very, very basic searches online, I found a lot more unsavory things. Women who were claiming that they blamed him for their children being stillborn or for the complications that they ended up having. It was really shocking that that much information was out there. And I had never really thought to look. I never Googled my own doctor. So, after finding even more terrible things out about him, I felt comfortable with the idea of leaving, even though it's scary for someone like me to not have a doctor in the middle of a pregnancy. My first choice was to see the local midwifery group through one of the main hospitals here. They come very highly recommended, and I had even spoken to a few people who had worked with them and said, I have some concerns because I've read that if you have any pre-existing issues, they don't like to work with you. And because I have hypertension, that did make me nervous, but my then current doctor never brought up my blood pressure. It's very well controlled with medication. And he just never really, he never said anything about needing to prevent preeclampsia or anything like that. So I had kind of let myself believe that my hypertension wasn't an issue. When I called for the appointment, at no point did they ask me any major probing questions. I made two appointments at the same time. One was for an OBGYN that I had previously seen 6 years ago, and then another was for the midwifery group. And I was really leaning towards working with them. And the OBGYN group asked me, I was on the phone with them for an hour and a half, two different phone calls. One was 45 minutes, one was an hour and a half, going through family history, medical history, medications, all sorts of things. And the midwifery group just kind of asked me my name and insurance, and that was it. I really wish that they had at least asked me if I had any pre-existing conditions, because it would have saved me the heartache of dealing with what I had to deal with. So I kind of put all my eggs in that basket, really thinking that that's what I was going to do, because the OBGYN I had seen 6 years ago, I left for a reason. So I really didn't love the idea of going back to her, but there are other doctors in that practice that I had originally called to see if I could see them. And they were like, you can't do that. So I really wasn't even considering that as an option. A couple of days beforehand, before I was supposed to meet with them, I called and canceled the appointment. I was like, you know what? I'm really sorry, but I don't want to waste the doctor's time. I plan to work with a midwifery group. Thank you for, you know, taking the time to update my files and everything. And they were fine with that. Then, fast forward to week 21, which was 3 weeks after I made the appointment with the midwifery group, I got a phone call the day before my appointment. And it was the midwife that I was going to be meeting with the next day. And I made a long, tearful, ranty video about that encounter. It was only like a 15-minute phone call, but boy, did I have a lot to say about it. I was really upset because after the fact, it kind of hit me just how condescending she was being. At the time, I couldn't tell if she was being caring or if she was just trying to talk down to me. But then retelling the story, you know, recalling things with Mike and with my sister, just, you know, telling them what happened, they agreed and I realized it was very, very rude. So I know that it's likely they probably just prepare for their patients who are coming in the next day and look at their files. I really wish that that hadn't been the case. I wish at some point, because my files got there 3 weeks prior, I wish that at some point someone would have looked that over and called me so I didn't have to waste 3 weeks of my pregnancy waiting to talk to somebody who would call me the day before my appointment and say, we're not gonna work with you because you have hypertension. And at that point, I had canceled the appointment with my other OB. I had pulled my files from the other and I had found more bad things out about him, so I didn't wanna go back. I was feeling incredibly stressed. I had a lot of questions that I wanted to ask someone and I just was feeling stuck. And then I went through a list of names. Someone I know had told me that her mother used to work with a surgery center at the hospital and she made sure that her daughter saw this one particular doctor because she was so good in surgery in case anything were to go wrong. And you guys know that that's just something that's always in the back of my mind. I always worry about the worst. And I called her office and just blissfully unaware that this was an issue. And they were like, we don't take transfers after 20 weeks. Which honestly makes sense. It makes total sense. But I was completely caught off guard by that. I really had no idea that that was even a consideration, that a doctor's office would be like, we don't do that. She said, the only way we do that is if you're moving here from out of state. But the midwife that called me basically said, she was just very, very condescending. She was like, do you know what a midwife is? How did you hear about midwifery? And I could tell she wasn't even really listening to my answers. When I answer her, and I wasn't being long-winded, I just would start to answer her and she would just sort of, okay, and blow me off. And then she was like, I see here you have high blood pressure and that's called hypertension. And we can't work with you because of what a midwife is. And I'm like, okay. So, and I just immediately started crying. Now, honestly, anything would make me cry at this point. I saw birds bathing on the side of the road in a puddle after a rainstorm. It made me sob. So this was upsetting, but it wasn't enough to make me cry. It was just that I had been very emotional and I had mentally just really thought that this was going to be my next step. So she was saying things like, you know, I don't know if you know, but when you have hypertension, you have to be careful of a condition called preeclampsia. Do you know what that is? Have you heard of that before? And I was like, yes, I'm very aware, and that's something that I was always concerned about. She's like, okay, so you can see why I couldn't work with you under those conditions. And I mean, because they're through a hospital and they work with doctors, I really thought that that was going to be fine. But that was foolish on my part to make that assumption. And I was really upset. And I was trying not to let her know that I was crying, obviously, but at one point she heard me sniffle and she's like, I can tell that I'm upsetting you. And it was just really, really frustrating to be talked to like that. I mean, how would I have known? At the very least, the person who took my name down for the appointment could have just asked. Somebody could have called me and talked to me for 5 minutes. The other doctor's office called me 2 times and talked to me for almost 2 hours combined, just about my history and about my situation, and really dug through my history. So I thought, you know, I think I learned a lesson here, because I don't know if that's how she always talks to people, but I wouldn't have wanted to work with her anyway if that's how she talks to people. And she kind of wouldn't let me go at that point. I was like, okay, well, thank you very much. And she was like, well, I hope right about now you're starting to feel movement and little baby kicks. And I hope that Michael can feel those kicks in a couple of weeks. And it was like, lady, enough. You're not gonna sugarcoat what you just put on me, okay? It's just not gonna work. So I tried to do some more research on new places and other places, but most people in the area who have given birth have recommended either the office I just left or the one I had canceled with. So I decided to call back the office that I'd canceled with. I totally had my tail between my legs and I said, I don't know if I'm not welcome, but I wanted to see if I could still see the doctor. And she was like, I don't see why not. Let me contact her. They got back to me within a couple of hours and I had an appointment the next morning at like 8:30 in the morning. And she was wonderful. And she was so understanding and she really listened to me. And she heard the story about the midwifery group and what they had said. So she told me, you know, yes, preeclampsia is something that is a concern, but the likelihood that I would get it is only a very small percent more than the average woman. And she said that there's more of a chance that I would not, you know, if you look at the odds, more of a chance that I would not get it than would, but they obviously will take precautions to make sure that they're on top of things in case that happens. And this is nothing that my previous doctor had discussed with me, so I feel more comfortable already. She said that she wants me to start having a monthly ultrasound starting at week 28, and then every week for 20 minutes, I have to be hooked up to a monitoring band, which will monitor the baby's heart rate. It's a non-stress test, just to kind of make sure that they're monitoring the situation and seeing if there's any effect of my blood pressure on the baby and etc. So I just felt like I could breathe again after I talked to her. It was amazing. I also discussed my concern with how much weight that I have gained. It's funny because since that appointment, I haven't gained more. And for a while, it felt like every time I stepped on the scale, it was another pound, it was another pound, it was another pound. And it would never go down. But lately, I've been kind of floating around the same. I'll either go down 2 pounds or back up to the highest point I've been, which is like between 18 and 20 pounds. And I know that I can't maintain that. I'm certainly not trying to lose weight, but my doctor said, I think you're fine. It's really not that bad. So I talked to her about what I had done to lose weight before conceiving, and she said that I could speak with a diabetic nutritionist if I wanted to, but basically all they would do is recommend that I count carbs, which is similar to what I was doing before. She said, just not as extreme. And she seemed pretty confident that I would be fine, and she really didn't have any major concerns for my weight. She really didn't, and I've had doctors be really blunt with me before, so I was kind of expecting that. And in a way I was almost disappointed that she wasn't like, oh my God, what's wrong with you? But it did feel a little bit comforting. I just feel like because I was so big when I conceived that I'm not comfortable with gaining a lot of weight. I wanna be as healthy as possible considering the circumstances. And even though I haven't really gained more weight in the last couple of weeks, I do feel like my face looks heavier. Even just like when I'm editing my videos, I'm kind of surprised by how heavy I feel like my face looks. And that could just be bloating and swelling, not actual weight gain, but I talked to you guys already about the pregnancy nose thing, so I just feel like I'm noticing changes in my appearance. And it isn't a vanity thing at all. It's me just trying to kind of keep an eye on my inflammation level, first of all. I know that my wrists feel like they've gotten bigger. Sorry, I have some makeup swatches on my wrists from earlier today, but I feel like I can tell that I have a little bit of inflammation in my wrists, and I know that that was some of what was causing the cramping and aching and sort of carpal tunnel feelings. Since I cut out fruit and have cut back on sugar, not completely, but I have cut back pretty considerably, I haven't really felt as much of a problem with my hands. It goes away much more quickly in the morning, that sort of like crunchy joint feeling where I can't actually move my hands as well as I'd like. But as far as everything else is concerned, it's pretty much the same. I don't have a set amount of weight that I'm comfortable with gaining. I don't have like a goal that I'm trying to stay under. I feel like that would only allow me mentally to like get to that point, if you know what I mean. So I just wanna be healthy. I just wanna have a safe and healthy delivery as much as possible. I wake up in the middle of the night now, and instead of just being scared momentarily when I first wake up that something's gonna be wrong and that the baby's not with us anymore, the first thing I think of is like, how am I gonna mentally cope with maybe never seeing her because something goes wrong? And I feel like that is such a sad way to think, but I'm just trying to kind of keep myself in line, if that makes sense, and do my best. You know, there's only so much I can do about something that could just go wrong, but if I can prevent a lot of issues by not going, you know, ballooning out of control or letting my blood pressure get crazy, then I want to do that. So another thing that she said, which is something that I was kind of expecting because of the PCOS and because of the weight gain, and because of the insulin resistance and all of that, that I would be taking my 1 hour glucose test early. She said normally early is 24 to 27 weeks, but she wanted me to do it before 24 weeks. So she gave me, her nurse gave me the little drink, and they told me to go before my appointment on September 19th, which is my follow-up with her. So I could do that at any point, really, and I'll be out of town the week before that, so I definitely need to do it before then, and I'd like to do it sooner than later, but I guess I just feel nervous about it. I don't know. I can't not feel nervous. But as soon as I find out how that works, I'll include that in one of my upcoming videos. Cross your fingers for me. Because the 1 hour test sounds like a breeze, but the 3 hour test sounds awful. I have been noticing some other physical changes. Luckily, that breathing panic has subsided. It really only happened for about a week or two, and the last couple of weeks I've been fine. I know that I'm not going to be rid of that completely. I know that's going to come back. But I'm just enjoying the time that it's not happening right now. In the meantime, I'm just kind of thankful that it hasn't happened. But I have been feeling like everything's sort of very dry. My mouth feels very dry all of the time. My eyes feel very dry. Wearing contacts is a nightmare. When I'm working or editing videos, I cannot wear my contacts. If there's one thing I wish I had done and not put off before getting pregnant, it is LASIK eye surgery. I wish I had gotten my eyes done. I always just sort of felt like, oh, I can do that at any point, and I would always put it off. I never had a good reason not to do it. I would just always put it off. But honestly, it would be so nice if I didn't have to wear contacts or glasses. I obviously prefer the way I look without glasses on, but I just don't like the way glasses feel on my face. It just feels sweaty, and they always feel dirty no matter how well I clean them. They just always feel dusty and dirty and fingerprinty, even though I swear I never touch the lenses. There's always some kind of, you know, Mike will give me a kiss and his nose will smudge across the lens, and just I just hate wearing glasses. But I don't think there's much I can do about that, which is, again, is fine. I am not complaining. These are not things that are an issue. It's just things I've noticed about my body. I also feel like my hair is straighter and a lot less frizzy. I'm gonna miss that. We have had one of the hottest summers on record, I think in the United States in general, but in our area as well, specifically. So normally I would never be able to straighten my hair at all. Normally I have to wear my hair natural until like September or October. I cannot this time of year straighten my hair at all. And I've been able to straighten my hair a lot. In fact, it feels like it just wants to be straighter. It has not been bothered by the humidity whatsoever. It doesn't frizz. It's been kind of a dream. So I'll definitely miss that. When my sister was pregnant, her hair just was so staticky and she hated it. She hated how her hair felt, but I've been quite enjoying mine. The other thing I think that might be going on, and I tried to do a little bit of reading on this online, and it seems like it's not really a thing. Or if it is, it might signal that there's something else going on, is I've been feeling like I'm experiencing hearing loss. And if I had to guess, it's because of the extra blood flow in my body. You know, I've told you guys I have that sort of whooshing sound in my right ear. Oh, you okay, kitty? You know, I told you guys I have that like whooshing sound in my right ear. It's always there. It's kind of always there to some degree, but I feel like it blocks my ability to hear because I feel like it just is muffled. And I know that this side isn't as affected, but I feel like because of the loss on this side, it prevents me from hearing well altogether. So I'll have to ask my doctor about that. I don't know. It could be unrelated. It could be earwax buildup or something, but I'm pretty sure it's not. Other than that, I think it was week 21 when I noticed that my belly was starting to feel a lot more firm. And sometimes it almost feels hard, like really, really hard and resistant if I were to sort of press against it. But even Mike has said that he thinks that it feels a lot more firm, especially this week, obviously. But week 21 is where I really started to notice it. And it's not all the time, which is strange. It's more when I'm standing up than when I'm sitting down, but I love it. I love having her in there. In week 21, I wasn't experiencing regular movement. I could feel it every now and then, and sometimes predictably, like when I first lay down at night or when I first sit up in the morning. But after I received that call from the midwife and I was so upset, and I got off the phone with her and I was just kind of giving myself a minute to recover because I was so angry, I never felt as much movement up until that point as I did that day. And it was almost like she was in there going, hey, if everything's fine, I'm just saying hi and just reminding you that everything's good. And it was so nice. It was perfect timing because I almost felt like I wanted to still be mad just so I could kind of get it out of my system, and I couldn't. It was impossible. I was so, so happy feeling her moving around and doing whatever the heck she was doing. She was really having a party there, so I was really grateful for that. So thank you guys so much for watching, and that is it for week 21. I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.